Hello everyone, I am welcoming all to the session 4 of unit 2, that is functional specification with use cases. Organization of the session. In this session, we are discussing a case study named Student Management System. Use case diagram activity. We are doing one activity based on use case diagram. Student management system. A student management system, in the simplest form, uses a digital tracking system to maintain a record of all the students. This student management system helps in the digital tracking, means since the university level, the college level, it is very difficult to manually maintain all the records of each and every student. Since the database is a very difficult task, what this student management system does is it helps in the digital tracking. That is, we are developing a software to maintain a record of all the students. For example, if a student enters to a particular university or the college, the database of a particular student starts with his name and university register number, that will be unique for him, and based upon the USN number, the entire database of the student will be tracked. For example, if a student joins to a particular university or the college, the database starts with his name, date of birth, and USN number, and the year of joining, the course he has joined, and has the year goes on, the additional informations like first semester percentage marks, second semester percentage, third semester percentage, like that. At the last, it will be calculated as an overall percentage of the during this academic year. If we maintain these kind of database, it is very easy for the administration and the university level to keep track of all the students. If we do it manually, it will be very difficult. A student database management allows schools, colleges, or the universities to save and access these records as needed by them, thus simplifying the work of the administration team. As I said, digital tracking of these databases will really help the management team and the administration team to maintain the records of the students. So once we record the students, that will be accessed by anywhere, anytime, easily, without any ambiguity. Now we'll see what all the things that can be done in this student management system. Student information system provides capabilities for It provides the capabilities for registering the students in the courses they have opted, documenting their grading, what is the percentage marks or what is the grading they have acquired in these years, transcripts, and as well as the results of the student test. Once the student opts for a particular courses, there will be a classes and there will be a test conducted for these courses. So once the completion of every courses, we have to give the results of the students, and these results can also be uploaded in this so that easily students can track their results. Even the parents can see the students' results easily. It helps in other assessment scores, like other activity scores or the project scores or the curriculum activity scores. Building the student schedules, saying that what is the schedules of the students, what exactly they should do in their college time. We can build their timetables or schedules the timetable for all the subjects they have to learn. Very importantly, we can track the student databases and the attendance. Attendance we can track by sitting anywhere and managing the other student related data needed. So using this, we can also maintain the attendance anywhere, and we can also manage any other student data like what is the last data to submit the assignments, and how we can evaluate the assignments, and how the students can get the information of these assignments. All these can be easily tracked. Information system is one of the key systems for facilitating the management and development of higher education systems. As we all know that information system plays a very important role in the current system. So this is very helpful for facilitating the management, administration team, and as well as a staff for all the higher education institutes. Using this, they can easily maintain the database of each and every students without any ambiguity. Now we'll see how we can construct a use case diagram for this. If you could see in the diagram, the use case diagram mainly consisting of four main actors or four main users. That is, at the extreme left, we can see an actor called super admin. Below that, we have an actor called system user. At the right hand, we can see the actors like faculties. Below the faculties, we have an actor called student. So these are the possible actors we are defining in the particular use case. We can also define any other use case, any other actors or primary actors depending upon the applications that we are going to develop. In this example, we are defining a four actors or four primary users. First one is super admin, second one we have a system user, third one we have is faculties, fourth one we have student. Now we'll see what are the subsystems or what are the activities or the use cases that we can define for all these primary actors. Yeah, the first user we have is super admin. As the name itself indicates that he'll be superior and he'll be having a administration control over all the users who are using this management system. The first use case we can define for the super admin is manage the user and fill the application. He is a super admin. He can manage all the users, including the faculties, including the students, and including the system user. But he has the capability to manage all the users and helps to fill the application. And the next possible use case is manage the student. So every year there will be a new students adding to the new courses and the new SEM. So the super admin will take care of managing the students every year for each and every courses. Super admin can also have a capacity of managing the fees. What could be the fee structure for the different courses and for the different semesters? Maybe it is an administration fees, or maybe it is a library fees, or maybe it is a course fees. Any fees, everything will be managed by the super admin. Along with these things, super admin will also having a use cases like login and logout from the system. Whenever he wants to do any of the above activities, the super admin first needs to log in and continue with the process. Once he has updated all the things that he wants to do in a particular session, then he can log out. Next possible thing is he can update his profile. He can update his profile on the time being, and he can change the password whenever it is needed. So these are all the things that can also be done by a super admin. Apart from that, the other possible use cases for these are managing the logins. Since he is a supreme or a super admin of this application, he has to manage the logins of all the remaining people like system user, faculties, as well as a student. So he has the capacity of managing all the logins. And he also manages the profiles of each and everybody who are using the system. And he can also manage the course. Maybe every year we can add the new courses or we can change the modifications in the already existing courses. So these management of logins, management of profiles and management of the new course or the existing course will be taken care by a primary actor called Super Admin. Apart from that, we have a second primary actor called System User. So he comes below the Super Admin. This System User, before doing anything, he has to log in and do the things which is intended to do. That is, after login, he can update his profile. He can change the profile. In the absence of the Super Admin, the System User is able to manage the logins of the others like faculties and the students. He can also manage the profiles of the users. He can also manage the courses in the absence of Super Admin. So before doing any of these activities, the System User has to get the authorization from the Super Admin. He has to get login and do the activities he wants to wish and log out from the system. The next user or primary actor we have is faculties. So being a faculty of a college or the university, these primary actor will be having an authority to add the courses which they are handling. They can also add the exams in which they are conducting. After conducting the exams, they can also publish the results. So being a faculties, there will be in the every semester, there will be a change on the courses, change in the pattern of the exams they conduct, change in the results in the format they publish. So it is a faculty related data that he can modify whenever he wishes. So before doing all these things, as I mentioned in the earlier actors, the faculties has to get login credentials and he has to update his profile, or he can change the password at his need. So once he has authorized user, then he can do any of the activities he can do. That is, he can add the any courses, he can add any exams he wish to conduct, or he can publish the results to the students. And the last primary actor we have is student. So once the student gets admitted to a particular course, he has to get a login credential from the Super Admin or from the system users. As I said in the beginning, every student will get a login credentials. He has to get login. Once he is successfully logged in, he can update his profile or he can change the password at his wish. Once the login process is complete, he can view the results for the exams which he has taken. He can view the fees of a particular course. He can also make the payment depending upon the requirement. The students can view the results, he can view the fees, or he can make the payment depending upon his need. So these are the possible use cases we are defining for the students. As I said in the earlier, it need not be same for all the applications of student database system. It may differ and it may be different depending upon the needs of the thing which we are developing. In this example, we are considering a basic use cases that are related to the uses that we have defined. Now we'll see. This use case diagram is a graphic depiction of the interactions among the elements of the student management system. Nothing but a graphic depiction of the interactions among the actors in the use cases. As we are representing these users and the use cases with the help of a diagram, so use case is generally a graphic depiction of the interaction that happens between the actors and the use cases. It represents the methodology used in system analysis to identify, clarify, and organize system requirements of student management system. So this diagram is very helpful in the identifying the students, clarifying the any things related to the student data, organize. That is very important, because since the number of students may be in large number in the particular college or the universities, organization will become a tedious job. So organization of all the students' information is very much easier if we use this particular kind of methods. Now, the example in which we have taken will define what are all the possible actors in that particular diagram. The relationships between and among the actors and the use cases of student management are: first actor we have is super admin entity. Use cases of super admin are: manage the student, he can manage the student, he can manage the fees, manage the logins of system user, faculties as well as the students. He can also manage the profiles of all these three users. He can manage the courses, like he can add the courses, he can delete the courses, or he can edit any changes in the existing courses. He can manage the exams or manage the uses of this database and full student management system operations. So he is a supreme power. He'll be the super admin entity, and he'll be having all the rights to manage all the three users of a system. The next actor we have is system user entity. Use cases of system user are: manage the student, manage the fees, manage the logins of all the students, manage the profiles, manage the courses, and manage the exams. These user will comes under the super admin user, where he can do almost all the things what the admin can do in his absence. He can manage the every student who wish to be a part of it, manage the fees, manage the logins, manage the profiles, and manage the examination details of every students of the university. Third actor we have is faculty entity. Use cases of faculties are: add courses. Since the faculties are responsible for the courses which they have opted, they have the authority to add the courses which they are handling, add the exams for the defined courses, conduct the exams, publish the results, and also view the student entity. So faculties are mainly responsible for adding the courses, conducting the exams, and publishing the results. Fourth actor we have is students. We'll see the use cases of students. These are: view the results, they can use the fees and make a fees payment as per their requirement. So these are the possible use cases of the actor that we have defined in our diagram. Now, in this session, we'll do one exercise and activity based upon this use case diagram. In the previous session also, we have taken an example of university auction system and defined the possible use cases. In this session also, we discussed an use case of student management system and how we can identify the different uses, different use cases, and how we can establish the connection between these actors as well as a use cases. Now we'll see how to write a use case diagram of our own when the requirements are being given. So this is an activity that we are doing. When we are asked to draw the use case diagram for any requirement, what we are supposed to do? What are the steps that we need to do? In this session, we'll discuss what could be the possible use cases, what could be the possible actors, and how we can derive a relationship between these users and the system. In order to identify the actors as well as the system, what could be the steps that can be followed by us? As we all know that for every problem, there will be a systematic approach. When we follow the systematic approach, definitely there will be a more efficiency in the software that we are developing. For that situation, we are also considering one solution for the previous exercise, and these solution will be identified with the following steps. What we should do when we should start with a use case diagram? First step, identify the requirements and put them in an oval shape. First, we have to identify the requirements, in the sense what are the things that is required for us. Based upon these requirements, the second step is we should identify the uses that are required to fulfill the above stated requirements. Third step, identify the relationship between the uses as well as the use cases. These relationship may include extent and the generalization, that is inheritance, maybe a parent or maybe a child. And we should also decide when we can use the extent clause, when we can use the inheritance. After defining these basic things, and we should finalize that what is the most suitable relationship among these use cases. So, use case diagram starts with identifying the requirements. We have to identify the uses, and mainly we should identify the use cases by extent, inheritance, and identifying the relationship. What is the fourth step? In this step, we have to draw the boundary. In the fifth step, we should connect the actors and the user with the use cases. As I said, once the actor has been identified, once the use case has been recognized, we should establish a connection or the relationship or the association with the actors and the use cases. With these preliminary steps, step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, and step 5, we can start writing the use case diagram for any of the applications. Now we'll take an example and we'll do one activity based upon the points that we discussed in the previous slides. As we all know that most of us are making use of a social networking website, right? Everybody will be having a account in a Facebook or the Twitter, right? So we all know that how exactly it looks like and what are the basic things it asks before any proper access of the particular account. In this activity, we'll discuss how we are creating use cases for this social networking website. Think that we are developing a social networking website with the following functionalities. I am defining a functionalities of my own. Any user can create a functionalities based upon his requirement. The first thing is the user should create his account, right? Before using any social networking website, the user first should create his account. After creating his account, the user can log into the system. After the successful login, with the successful login credentials, he can change his profile picture as he wish. That we have all experienced, right? The registered users should also be able to search for a friend. Maybe he is already having a friend in a particular website. He must be able to search for a friend. After searching a friend, maybe he can add the users or he can add the friend too, depending upon the requirements. Now, we'll see what could be the possible use cases that we can define with a social networking website. As we all know that the first use case that we can recognize here is register. The user should register. It is a first thing what the user can do is the user should first register. After register, user can log into the system. The process of registration is compulsory before the login. As we all know that we have to sign up for a particular website before using the login. So we should register ourselves in any of the site we are interested, and the process of registration is compulsory before going ahead. The second possible use case we are defining here is login. Once the user creates an account, now the user can log in every time without sign up. So once the successful registration, once the user creates his account, now he can log in every time without any registration. So he can keep on logging from anywhere at any time. He'll be given the access to his account. Next possible use case is login, upload the profile picture. When the user gets a login, there is a choice for the user. That user can upload a profile picture or not. So once the successful login, there will be a choice for the user. Has you all experienced that particular user can upload a picture or not, and it is not mandatory or compulsory. It totally depends on the choice of the user. Depending on his wish, he can change his profile picture whenever he needs. The next possible use case or login, search for a friend. When the user gets a login, now, there is a choice for the user. Whenever he gets the successful login, there is a choice for the user. That user can search for a friend or not. If he is interested, he can search for the friend that he has already known, who are already using a same social networking website. Use case 5. Search a friend and add the friend. When the user gets a login, there is a choice for the user that the user can search a friend or not. When a user searches a friend, then there is an option that the user adds a friend or not. As I said, when the user logins with a proper credential, there will be a choice that he can search a friend or not. When he's searching, there is an option that you can add a friend or not, depending upon his requirements. As I said, these are the possible use cases. That is, use case 1, he starts with a registration of the user, login of the user. After the login, he can upload the profile picture and he can search for a friend or he can add for the friend. So these are the possible use cases that we are identifying for a particular application, that is social networking website. Similarly, you can define the use cases of any of your choice that you need. This is not mandatory that you should define the same use cases for this same application. There can be a different use cases for the same application depending upon the applications that we are developing. With these use cases, you can do an activity of writing the use case diagram of your own, and the use case diagram may differ from one person to another person depending upon the use cases which he has identified, or the actors he has identified, or the relationship that he is identifying between the actors as well as the use cases. So every use case diagram may differ from one another. I hope with this you are all writing the use case diagram by considering these use cases. Now, with these activities, we'll also do the assignments at your end. So, what is that assignment that we can do with this knowledge? As I said, writing a use case diagram may be a differ for the different person from the for the same applications. So in this particular session, we'll discuss how to start with this use case diagram. So it is an assignment. Everybody should try at your end. The possible use case diagram that you can try at your end is library management system, hospital management system, and credit card processing system. Here we'll discuss what could be the possible use cases that we can define. I'll be giving a basic knowledge of these use cases, but you should try writing the use case diagram of your own. The first application we are discussing here is library management system. In the library management system, what could be the possible use cases? The first thing is the user has to register himself as a new user initially. So the user has to register himself for in the initial requirement. The actors that we can define in the library management system is there will be a user. The user may be a staff or maybe the student. There will be a librarian, that is a main actor here. Librarian will be the main actor. Under the librarian, we are having one staff as a actor and student as an actor. So initially, to start with, everybody has to log in with this system. After the registration happens, you can go ahead. After the registration, he can get a library card of his own, or he can request for a desired book, or he can renew the book, or he can return the book. So these are the possible use cases that we can define in the library management. Similarly, the next assignment we have is hospital management system. We'll see what could be the possible use cases that we can define here. In the hospital management system, it allows to optimize and digitally able to manage all the databases of the hospital. This may be very useful in improving the customer service and processing the cost, streamlining the medical records, bills, as well as all the informations about patients as well as the doctor. So it is very important or the requirement of the hospital management system. In the hospital management system, we can define our use cases such as patients, there will be a doctor, there will be a system administrator. So every patient who is getting admitted to the hospital should be get a patient ID, which is unique, and what could be the problem they are having, what could be the date in which they are getting discharged. So all possible use cases can be defined. So at the administrative end, they'll be having a login for processing the bill, for the insurance claiming. All these could be an examples of use cases that comes under the hospital management system. You can think of your own requirement, or can define your own actors as well as a use cases. Since it is an assignment, you should think of your own and start identifying the actors, use cases, and writing the use case diagram. Third question in the assignment we have is credit card processing system. In the credit card processing system, we have how to process the card. As I say, and since it is a credit card, there should be an actors like a bank as well as a users. So the users should first give the application for the credit cards that he is willing. The bank has to approve for the credit card. The bank will take care of the annual income of a customer and what the customer is expecting the service, and what could be the maximum amount he can get in his credit card, and what are all the due dates, and what are all the good things that he can done with his credit card. So this can also have many use cases depending upon the application. The two main users here we have is, one is a bank customer, the other is a bank. So there will be a, before starting any of these interaction, there will be an authorized connection between a bank as well as a customer. Once the bank recognized the customer as a genuine customer of the bank, then he can start the credit card processing. Here also you should need to identify the different scenarios for the application, identify the users, identify the use cases, and also establish the connection. Hope you all do these assignments by writing a use case diagram for these three applications. Thank you.